Now, let's bring in our panel where we now have former Victorian Liberal Party President Michael Kroger, as well as here at the desk, Sky News senior reporter Carolyn Marcus. Thank you guys both for joining me tonight. Now, I want to stick on this Biden thing for just a little bit here. And we did have that hint from Joe Biden that he could use his health as an excuse to withdraw from the White House. Just want to play a little bit of that grab just again here.
If there had some medical condition that emerged, if the doctors came to me and said, you got this problem, that problem.
Now, Michael, I mean, you know, just even you almost needed subtitles to listen to what he was saying there. But this is a huge call, and this is the first indication that that real stubborn, I'm going to stay no matter what, and who comes, you know, saying it's time to go, I might actually go. What do you think of this? What do you make of the politics of this, Michael?
Well, mate, as you know, I've been saying for weeks, Biden's not running. He's going to withdraw. Between now and the 19th of August, which is the start of the Democratic convention, Biden will announce he's withdrawing. He's not going to withdraw because of COVID, obviously. If he's got something more serious, that's a different story. But this guy is not running. There is zero chance that Joe Biden will be the Democratic candidate at this election. And someone should tell all those people and all those American commentators who say, oh, he might do this is happening and Schumer's saying this. No, it's over. It was over weeks ago. This guy's not running. He will stand down, and there's a 90% chance, I would think, that Kamala Harris will be the candidate. She'll do a lot better than people think, by the way. But if an election's held tomorrow, Trump wins 324 to 214. He wins by more than 100 college votes. I don't include North Carolina because that's Trump won one of that. But Trump wins the seven swing states. He wins Arizona, Nevada, Wisconsin, Michigan, Georgia, Pennsylvania, and Virginia. He wins all those seven. He wins by more than 100 college votes. The Democratic Party know that. This is over. It was over weeks ago. Someone's got to tell Joe and Jill because they're about the only two that don't know it's over, but he's not running.
Well, Caroline, this is fascinating to me, though, this whole idea that in an American democracy where Americans elect the presidents and it's not a parliamentary system where the party room can go and roll the leader. Is there something a little bit undemocratic about this idea that behind the scenes there's pushing out somebody who's the sitting president?
And apparently Donald Trump is the real threat to democracy, right? I mean, if it was Australia, he would have been out the door within like 24 hours.
Of course.
We have no problem. Our parties have no problems with rolling leaders,
yeah.
Do they? But look, I think I wouldn't say it's undemocratic. I think there has been a lot of pressure, obviously, behind the scenes, as well as people saying on the record now increasingly that they think that he should reconsider his re-election bid. People have been quite forthright about that. And that's part of, I guess, a country which values free speech and where people have a right to express their opinion, even if it's the leader of their own party. What I will say is that I think what Biden's language has been lately in interviews has been extremely telling. Think about what he said during the first interview after that disastrous debate where he said only the Lord Almighty could get him to stand down. Now it's a mere doctor. Now, I know a lot of doctors think they're God,
yeah.
But that is a step down, isn't it?
That is a little bit there. But, Michael, let's talk, though, a bit about sort of what comes next here, because there has been reports that the Democrats are going to push back the time when people go, when the delegates go to cast their official votes, to push it back to the convention. So it seems to me that there's a couple of factions involved here. There's some people who want to just anoint Kamala Harris. And I agree with you that if she did stand, she would do better than people think, particularly in the suburbs and with suburban women. But there's also a group that wants to throw it open, I think, at the convention and have the messiness of an open convention. Who's going to win here, the backroom boys or the delegates on the floor?
No, the backroom boys are going to win and girls.
Of course they are.
They can't have an election on the floor. Look, for a whole host of reasons, it has to be Harris. She's the ranking VP. She's a black woman. But the most important reason why, you know, stick with me here, James, the most important reason why she'll get the nomination is this. The Democratic Party leadership is so incredibly weak. No one's actually running this show. We've got congressmen here. We've got Chuck Schumer there. We've got George Clooney, an actor there. I mean, no one's running it. So for them to coalesce around anyone but the vice president would take them 6 months. So she's the ranking figure. She's got $200 million in the bank. They've got nothing. And she'll run. And the establishment wouldn't have enough power, time, energy, prestige, you know, moral authority to coalesce behind anyone else. That's why it'll be Harris. The only alternative to that is if Michelle Obama says she's running, Harris would probably step down for Michelle Obama. But I see no evidence at all that Michelle Obama wants to run. You would have seen some leaks, some indication, but there's absolutely nothing. So I presume she's not running. So they can't have a contested election. Biden is going to announce that he's standing down. But he will do that before the convention, which then means that they can have her as a coronation as the only candidate. They'll try and do what the Republicans have done with Trump. It's a coronation. They won't want a bloody mess on the floor of the convention where Gretchen Whitmer and Gavin Newsom and her and whoever else. That would be a catastrophe for the Democratic Party. So they'll anoint her. She'll announce she's running. A few days after that, everyone else will announce they're not running and she'll get the nomination unopposed. That's what's going to happen.
Now, Caroline, I want to get to your exclusive in a moment about pro-Hamas propaganda being shown in a Sydney school. But before we get to that, I just want to ask you, you know, we showed a little bit of J.D. Vance there. I thought he was incredibly impressive. And I thought that it was incredible because two things. Number one, he's 39, so he's really young. So this is generational change. Number two, he was talking about the nation and the family of a nation in a way that I don't think I've heard a politician speak in a long time. And even in Australia, where immigration is a big issue, I don't think we talk at all about national family and the way that we work together in that sort of way. What did you make of that?
I think he's such a strong pick, and I've really enjoyed hearing a lot more from him and about him in the last few days, because there were so many other names mentioned as possibilities and so many other ways he could go, which and a lot of people who really had a lot going for them. But perhaps, you know, to pick a fellow white male, I think it's kind of like a strong, it's strange, but these days to have two males running on the ticket is almost like wild, because you almost have to pick just a diversity pick. But when you think about it, JD Vance does represent a lot of the forgotten people of America who are Trump's base and who are people that feel that they've been really let down by Biden's immigration policies and economic policies. And that's who he really is speaking to. So I think it was a really clever, confident pick.
And I think it's interesting because I think what we see now is the Republicans picking up all the people that Democrats have lost now that they've gone and become the party of Wall Street and pronouns and all of that.